Hey guys, Pastor Jeremy Sutton here with my good friend Woody Robinson. We're in a series talking about friendship, and I want to talk to you today specifically about this quote. A true friend protects your weaknesses, and a true friend never exposes you to the enemy. Talk to me about that, Brother Woody.
A lot of people like to tell everyone else's business. They like to tell the story that's happening. A lot of people like to be mixed up in the drama. But a real friend doesn't want to see your weaknesses exposed, doesn't want to see you hurt, doesn't want to see your life fall apart. Yeah. And you need to be surrounded by people who know what your weaknesses are, help you work on them so they're not your weaknesses, so that you move toward your strengths. But they don't expose you to your enemies. They don't throw you under the bus. They don't make fun of you. They don't mock you in front of other people. Mm. Remember, people treat you how they feel about you.
Isn't that good? I was thinking about the dynamic of Saul, Jonathan, and David. Three very powerful men. Jonathan had to make a decision. And that is in itself that power of Jonathan having to make a decision whether to honor blood, family, or to honor friendship. Jonathan chose friendship. It's amazing because he understood the power of divine connection. And a lot of times people will choose blood over friendship. And that's fine, and I understand where you're coming from. And you have to hear from God. But Jonathan understood that the next king of Israel was going to be David. And he honored that word that he got from the Lord to honor the friendship of David. And the rest is history, because you'll see that, how that lineage runs out and how that relationship runs out. And David begins to honor that friendship even after Saul and Jonathan are dead.
He does.
And so he understood friendship. Jonathan understood friendship. And so today we're talking about never allowing people in your lives to expose you. Jonathan never exposed David.
Even though he could have.
He could have.
Because Jonathan was supposed to have been the next king.
Ooh, wow. But he loved friendship so much that he honored David. He honored God's way of doing things, because Samuel comes and says, I've got to anoint the next man.
Right.
And David's the man.
He is.
Golly, that's so good. So today, you have to have a relationship with God, number one, to understand who God brings in your life. Honor those relationships. Honor those friendships. Because in that, you may very well help the next person become the next king of Israel. That's good stuff.
Or the next manager at your store.
Or the next pastor of a city. Or the next worship leader. Who knows what God does through those God-ordained friendships and relationships. Man, it's fun. This is fun. We love you today. Hope you know that we're for you. And furthermore, God is for you. We love you today. Remember, church, great days are ahead.